Absolutely that yourself, Mikey.
Alright, so I live on the Gold Coast with my girlfriend and my dog, and yeah, just make music. That's pretty much the gist of my whole life at the moment. Like Monday to Friday, or Monday to Thursday, I'm just at home making beats. And then on the weekends, I'm usually out touring around and performing at different places. I think right now is just the greatest time to be an Australian electronic music producer. Like even pretty recently, like even like 3 or 4 years ago, like before Flume exploded, like it was, I remember like playing DJ shows and feeling like it was a little bit taboo to play like much Aussie stuff. It was just like strictly, people just like didn't really feel Aussie stuff as much as they felt overseas stuff. And now it's like, people just want to hear Wave Racer and like, you know, like you could do a whole festival of Aussie acts and it would sell just as well as like internationals. It's amazing. And I think Flume was the breaking point of that. And then he opened up the door for like all the different avenues that are having success now. And it's just been, it's that was the start of like this amazing few years we've been having. Splendour was like the best thing that ever happened in my life. It was just so fun, like playing to like a crowd that big and having TK and Aaron and Maddie come up and sing on stage and stuff, and it was just so good. The crowd was just so great. Yeah, everything about it was super fun. I didn't even realize that I had a rider, like a drinks rider, and we were camping and stuff, and then on the last night someone told me where my drinks rider was. And I was like, what? I got beers here. And I like ran and just filled my backpack full of beers. And then like, I was just walking around like Father Christmas, like giving beers to like whoever needed beers. It was like the perfect end to the festival.
They think white girls got that.